Find the proofing tools on the review tab in the proofing group. The two we're going to talk about are spelling and thesaurus. We're also going to talk about autocorrect. Now, these tools are common throughout Office applications. So like other Office applications, PowerPoint offers spell check as you type. However, unlike Word, there's no grammar check in PowerPoint. So you won't see any green lines. Just like other Office applications, to correct a misspelling, I simply right-click on the word and can choose from the options of words that it thinks I meant. Like here, I type misspellings but put an extra S in, three S's instead of two. I have two other options, ignore all and add to dictionary. So ignore all the instances of this word being misspelled this time. If I were to open PowerPoint again, open a new presentation, and make the same mistake or same misspelling, it'll be flagged as a misspelling again. The second option, add to dictionary, tells PowerPoint or Office, because the dictionary is shared throughout all Office applications, to no longer flag this as a misspelling. Perhaps it's a proper name, a tech word, a city, a place name, something that the Office dictionary does not currently have. So add this word to the dictionary, no longer flag it as a misspelling. So it adds it to what's called the custom dictionary. So if I want to spell check my entire document, I click spelling up here, review tab, proofing group, or I can press F7. F7 is the keyboard shortcut to run the spell check. Spell check will start on the current slide, work to the end of the presentation, and then it'll ask you if you want to start at the beginning. So I'm going to run spell check real quick here, and you'll see on the right-hand side here we have the slide out for spelling. Now it flags the word and it gives me some options. Ignore this one time, ignore all, and this is the add to dictionary button. So here I can choose my correction and I can click change this one or change all misspellings in the document. So if I misspelled this word 10 times, let's say, change all will change every single one of them to the selection here I made of the correct one. So if I say change, it changes and it says I'm good to go. It didn't find any other spelling errors in the document. I'm going to undo that one second though, and I'm going to run spell check again, and down here we have a speaker icon. And I don't know if you can hear that in the recording, but if you click the speaker icon, the word is actually spoken. It'll actually speak the word for you. Now, down here we have a dictionary selection, and these are all the different dictionaries that we can spell check with. So lots of different dictionaries to change the language. I make a selection here, or I make a selection up here in language. Now we also have, as I said, we also have the thesaurus, which is another slide out. So let me choose a word here. Let's just use check. So if I highlight check and click thesaurus, check will be chosen, and these are all the synonyms for check. The synonyms for check are highlighted or boldfaced. And then synonyms for those synonyms are under the word. So payment is a synonym for check. And then synonyms for payment are payment, form, order, draft, authorization, etc. Then we have bill. If I click a word like form, if I click form, now we're going to get synonyms for form. And form could be a procedure, a ritual. If I click the down-facing arrow, I can insert that word into my document to replace the word I've highlighted, or I can just copy it. So that's how the thesaurus works. Now, thesaurus only have two different choices for language, either English United States or English United Kingdom. The thesaurus does not have as many choices as spell check. Now, I can just run the thesaurus without a word highlighted by clicking thesaurus or pressing Shift F7 and then just typing something. Well, I had the word highlighted. Let me do that again without a word highlighted. So I'm going to not highlight a word here. I'm going to press thesaurus. And it goes back to the first word on the slide. If you don't have any content on the slide, it'll just say synonyms await. And I can just type a word here. Let's say cake. And there's all the synonyms for cake. We have bar, we have cover, and then we have synonyms for those synonyms. So that's how thesaurus and spell check operate. Now, real quick, we can look at research. This is a proofing tool. We can search a search engine here, or we can search the dictionary or a thesaurus. So let's search Bing. Let's search for PowerPoint. And we will see here, we will actually get search results here in PowerPoint. Not sure how useful this is, just showing it to you. Also, we have autocorrect. So autocorrect will correct things. Like you see, I misspelled the here. It corrects it with the. Didn't know that one. It knows certain misspellings like apple. Well, there are certain misspellings that it'll correct. Let's look at those in options. So if I go to options here, go to proofing, autocorrect options, here's what we will autocorrect. So straight quotes, fractions, ordinals, hyphens, smiley faces, etc. Autocorrect. All right, so show autocorrect options. All right, so we're going to correct the two initial capital letters, capitalize the first things, replace text you type. Here's all of the corrections we're going to make. Lots of them here. Lots of common misspellings. Now I can add my own. For example, so when I say PPT, I want it to say PowerPoint. So let me go to a new slide here, or down here on this slide, and type PPT, and notice it automatically corrects it to PowerPoint. So I can add and use autocorrect as shortening things. For example, let's say I have to type the name of my company quite a bit. So let's go back to proofing here, autocorrect. And we're going to say SC with all right, so when I type SC and press the space bar, it's going to put the full name of this company out like that. So you can use this to shorten the amount of work you have to do typing. If I type something over and over and over, I can add it in autocorrect and actually have it use abbreviations and have them type out longer things. So returning here real quickly to autocorrect, we also have actions. So PowerPoint can produce additional actions for certain words or phrases in your document. That's beyond the scope of this course, but we can have when we type a word, something happens. So I can also use math autocorrect here again, above or beyond the scope of this course, but you kind of see what happens here. We type a word, we get a symbol. So in this lesson, we learned about proofing tools in PowerPoint, the spell check, the thesaurus, and autocorrect, to autocorrect misspellings, and using autocorrect to create abbreviations to simplify or decrease the amount of work we have to do typing.